I had a lot on my mind Friday night. I was preparing for Saturday. But man, when Hook and Fuego del Sol came on, 3 minutes, 100% attention to the screen. As noted, I thought it was awesome. Thought Hook looked great. Fans loved him.
Yeah, you brought up the NXT thing. Look, they would have never let it get this far without ruining it, you know? Plus, on top of it, you don't have the aesthetics. They'd never allow the aesthetic of, you know, they're using Wale to do the theme. That's great. But, you know, do you think Chairman's intent from Action Bronson was going to be used? You know, you think that money was going to be spent to go ahead and decide to do that for him? You know, this kid's just starting out, you know, and you go and I don't know what licensing is, but, you know, hey, it's all the Turner family Vice records. I don't know. Maybe it's cheaper than I think it is, but, you know, WWE would never do something like that and broker that kind of deal, especially for a guy that's just walking out there, you know, whose name wouldn't be Brock Lesnar, and they didn't even do that for Brock. So there's no way. You can't switch the positions, and I can't believe that anybody is blaming Dominic Mysterio more than they're blaming the system, but... You know, that to me is silly. When it comes to Hook, I wouldn't put him on TV, though. Like you're mentioning, putting him on Elevation or Dark, I actually wouldn't do that. I wouldn't bother doing something like that. He's on Rampage. He's on the main show on Dynamite, and that's it. That's it. When it's time to send for Hook, then you send for Hook. He can do enough work and pop up in enough places. If you want him to do indie shows, he can pop up at different places if you wanted him to. But I actually would not mess with the mystique at all of bothering to put him on Elevation or Dark. And that's not to put down anybody that's on those shows or anything like that. I just think, you know, if you really want to make him special, then go ahead and make him special.
Well, here's the deal with making this dude special. I don't care how you do it, but this guy needs to work. And
put him on indies.
If you're not going to put him on Dark and Elevation, then he needs to be doing indies every weekend.
That's right.
If he's not going to be doing indies every weekend, then he needs to be doing Elevation and Dark. But he needs to work. He needs to work. And the key is, he's 22 years old. So there's no need to rush this. You spend 2 years getting this guy work and getting him experience in front of people. And when you decide to pull the trigger on him in a big feud, 2 years from now, he's still only 24 years old. So there is a way to do this, and they've look at their own pillars, their four pillars. I mean, how long was it before Sammy Guevara ended up winning that title? You know, they put him in the Jericho's group, the Inner Circle, and they groomed him, and he did tag matches, and he was already far more advanced than Hook is at this point. But it was a couple of years before they finally pulled the trigger on him for that title. They have not pulled the trigger on the Jungle Boy yet, and they've been slowly bringing him up over the course of a couple of years. He was more advanced when he went to AEW than Hook is right now. MJF, way more advanced than Hook was when he came to AEW, and we're slowly grooming him to world championship matches here. So there is no hurry, but the guy needs to work one way or the other somewhere.
I think it would be great to see promoters send for Hook, you know, for Drew Cordero to send for Hook to be on, you know, uncharted territory on, you know, IWTV. You know, look at Wheeler Yuta. Look at all the people that have gotten, you know, a chance to work and a chance to get better and a chance to shine on through IWTV. Look at, can you imagine Hook showing up? Because Josh Barnett sends for Hook to be on Bloodsport on a GCW weekend or something like that. There's ways to get this guy a lot of work, especially obviously work every single day, you know, behind the scenes and wrestling and doing what you can. And no, that does not replace working with different people in different environments in front of different fans. He absolutely needs to do that. But I just don't think Elevation and Dark, I think to send him off and to continue to make him as special as you can, why, and just ride this wave while you can to go ahead and do that, I think keeping him off the other TV that you have is still the way to go.
Well, I'd have him do Dark and Elevation. That's just me. But I would keep him off Dynamite in big matches for the time being. Listen, if he's working Dark and Elevation, he's working with bros that you know and trust. And you have, listen, they got Adam Cole and guys like that that are working Dark and Elevation. So get him in there with good workers, working a lot of matches. Or, you know what, he doesn't even need to do singles matches. He's part of Team Taz. Get him in there doing tag matches on a regular basis. Let him get in there. He can work a little bit more each match. And away you go.
And look, and this is loosely related to this, but, you know, in New Japan, there's still the tradition of having seconds at ringside. And in the Japanese system, you know, you're used to seeing that. In AEW, more than anywhere else, I guess, well, outside the indies, I guess, you know, we see it with different factions and things like that. But, like, you know, you have the ability to do that there, and that's where I wish that would kind of come back more, especially in an area that's got so many factions and things like that, to have guys at ringside so these young guys can come down and watch your Dante Martins or your Hooks or people like that, to just to be around it. I think is, I always like that concept. I always like that idea. I'm a boxing fan. I'm a martial arts fan anyway, so I'm used to it. But I always like that aspect about wrestling, and I wish it would actually come back. It'll never come back in WWE, but I actually wish it would come back everywhere else.
Person here says if he does the darks and elevations, he won't be mysterious. He's not mysterious anymore. He was mysterious until Friday.
Wrong.
Now we know who
he
is.
You're wrong. No.
Get this guy.
See that face? You don't know what's going on.
Get the reps, this guy noted. He's right. Get them reps in.
Brian thinks he's an expert on the Hook. The Hook is an expert on you, Brian Alvarez. You don't even know this. You don't even know that man. Just like the song said, he was sitting there not saying a word, just looking, his back turned to his opponent, just looking up. You were wondering what Hook was thinking. I know that you were.
Everyone here saying I'm wrong knows nothing about actual wrestling. Like, he had 1 3-minute match, and yes, it was awesome. It was a fantastic debut. But bro, he's got to learn how to work. I'm sure he can work to a degree right now, but anyone on this planet, most of all his father, will tell you that the bro needs reps. Reps, 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 matches, 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 matches.
Yeah, okay, you can repeat it a million times. He doesn't have to have him on Dark. He doesn't have to have him on
These
Elevation.
Idiots.
He can have him on the scenes. He can have him before shows. He can have him after shows. He can have him out there in front of different crowds in other places. Why overdo the mystique of this guy? I mean, with anybody, let alone with him. Look, it's just one example. If somebody else was in this boat, same way. And again, this has got nothing to do with people that appear on Dark or Elevation, whether it be Adam Cole, CM Punk, whoever. It's just sometimes maybe some people shouldn't be on those shows. And if you have something special, then why bother with it? If you want to like have a short match with him showcasing, do it like you did with Fuego del Sol. Do it on Rampage. Make it a big deal every time out. Why not? Ride this wave,
bro. These people here that are advocating for the indies, yes, it would be nice for them to do indie matches as well, but okay, you can team Hook up with Hobbs, and let's think about the level of tag team talent that you have in AEW that you could get in the ring and work with. Who is he going to work with on the indies where he is going to be carried by a significantly better opponent in long matches? Nothing against anybody on the indies.
Wait a second.
Where are they going to send him?
Wait a second. This is how Daniel Garcia got to be as good as he is. This by facing guys like Davey Richards and people like that. I mean, for heaven's sakes, there's a reason how Lee Moriarty.
Joey
got
Janela
to that
is in AEW.
Joey Janela.
He doesn't have to go to the indies to wrestle Joey Janela.
There are a zillion people on the indies who are working right now. Again, like a Richards coming back. There are tons of guys. Josh Alexander. There are plenty of places that he can go. Imagine, look, they have a relationship. Imagine if he shows up to wrestle somebody on Impact or something. But again, even that's a pipe dream. Regardless, he can go and face a lot of people and get a lot of experience wrestling a lot of different people and have a lot more time than he would in a better match and a better opponent in some cases than he would on a Rampage or on an Elevation or a Dark show. I mean, if he faces Davey Richards or if he faces Vinny Massaro on a West Coast Pro show, isn't that better than doing 5 minutes against Fuego del Sol on you know, Dark or something
like
that?
He doesn't
need
to do 5 minutes on Dark. You can give him as much time as you want on Dark. They have Dark and Elevation. It doesn't have to be a 3-minute squash. And I'm not burying the indies. I'm pointing out that AEW has some of the best workers on the planet. And you guys want to send him to some random indie show instead of working with some of the best workers that you have under contract and trust just because you're afraid that Hook is going to lose his aura? Let me tell you something.
It's not about being afraid to lose the aura.
That's what this guy says.
Brian, okay, do me a favor. Let me know when you want to talk to me instead of arguing with 17 different people who have 17 different ideas, all of which are you're wrong at the end of the day of it. You know, I mean, there are wrestling ways to talk about this that actually can make some sense.
You're lucky there's a commercial right now.
Why?
Back in a moment, Observer Live.
It is Wrestling Observer Live today. I'm Oreo the Orca.
Do you have a blowhole rating system? Like, if you're really excited about a match, it gives you six squirts?
This match was 2 3/4 holes, if you must know. So I was watching this show, and they had a bunch of videos for this Liv Morgan about how, oh, my whole life I've been a wrestling fan. Oh, I'm going to win my first title ever. There's children cheering and going, oh, you know what I'm saying?
Okay. I do indeed.
Hey, Danhausen, can you hear us?
Yes, can you hear Danhausen?
Hey, look at that. Holy mother of God, look what we've done here. You broke a leg, is that true?
It was broken in half, snapped in two. The doctor said it was a tibia and a fibia.
I'm a whale and not a doctor, but is it not a fibula and not a fibia?
A fibula? Well, I know. Perhaps the doctor lied to Danhausen.
You know, Danhausen, if you were a whale, you wouldn't have broken your leg.
This is true because whales don't have legs.
What did you grow up watching as a little evil man?
Kane ripping off the door when he debuted.
Yes. How old were you, Danhausen, when that match took place?
Oh, about, 1997, so about 700 years old.
Oh.
Also, one time Danhausen had Dolph Ziggler's theme song as his alarm and it went off in class.
No, he didn't.
Yes, it's true. Danhausen likes Dolph Ziggler. You like Dolph Ziggler? He's good matches.
If you enjoy these videos, for just $7.99 per month, you can enjoy full-length editions of The Bryan and Vinny Show, Wrestling Observer Live, Figure Four Daily with Tom Lawler and Lance Storm, The Mad Men Podcast, Speak Now Pro Wrestling with Denise Salcedo and more, plus hundreds of archived shows, all in beautiful HD. Don't miss out. Join us today.